गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून, हेलो हेलो,
गुड आफ्टरनून सर,
गुड आफ्टरनून, माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल
सर,
माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल टू ऑल?
यस सर, ऑडिबल.
ओके ओके.
Yes, audible.
So, I have, all of you, I think, come, na? Someone, students is waiting for that. Okay, we can start now. Anyone can check your copy that in the last classes, which things we have completed? Anyone can check your copies? Anyone can check your copies? Hello? Shubham Ghosh, Shubham Ghosh, please show your copy in the last, whatever the last lecture I can talk told to you. Hello, hello, Shubham, Shubham Ghosh.
Sir, caliper tak hua tha, sir.
Caliper?
Yes, sir. Digital caliper.
Okay, yeah, thik. Yahan tak hua tha, na? Okay, thik, digital caliper, na?
Sir.
Okay, that is okay. So this, I think my skin is visible to all. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Up to that you have completed, na? Digital caliper?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So So from that, anyone can present. So this we are already discussed about the total calipers we are used in the workshop. So this total 7 calipers we are discussed individually. What are the why the use in this particular calipers? What are the use particularly for the workshop? Okay. Now we have discussed. So the measuring tool actually we are discussing. So from up to that, steel rule and measuring tape we are already discussed. Surface plate also discussed. Then calipers we are discussed. So three measuring tool we are already discussed. Now we can discuss the divider. Okay. Divider, tri-square, vernier height gauge and the micrometer. So this is the one of the instrument which will we have. This is the one of the instrument which will we have used for the marking tool as well as measuring tool also. So the divider is a similar to in construction with the caliper. So the same things which will we have done in the caliper also. But the caliper, whatever the dimension which will be given for this particular instrument, it will be same as that divider also. Okay. Except that the both legs are straight with the sharp hardened points at the end. So in the caliper, which will be have bended, which will be, we know that in the outside caliper and the inside caliper, which will be have the legs will be bent. But here, when you consider as a divider, the legs all are straight, and then point edge point which will be have some nip edges point. Okay. So in this particular cases, what is we can do? I just show you that. Suppose this is our workpiece. Okay. This is our workpiece. I just. Here, this is the center line of this particular workpiece. Okay. What can measure? Suppose I want to draw a very straight line. Okay, I want to draw a straight line. Okay. So what is that do? I just first put the one leg here, and another leg just put it in here. Okay. So suppose here, just in this particular point, not here, in this particular point, and move from here to here. So these two lines are parallel to each other. So that is actually we have draw by this particular use of the divider. Okay. So that is the use actually. That is one point is placed at the center of marking and the exact center and the circle. Or you have to have a draw a circle or you have draw the straight line. And then we are going to use the divider. Okay. So these things which we have started from here. One leg which will be put in this particular point and another leg which will be put in here. Okay. And we have moved from here to here. So this is this line which will we have draw after before we have draw the center line of this particular workpiece.
So that is the use of this divider. And there is a, so many things which will be have no, according to the calipers also, same things which will be have, that is the leaf spring which will be provided. And there is a pivot which will be joined these two leaf. Okay. And here, this is the knot which will be have tightened and the loose by this particular two legs. Okay. And this is the leg point. Now, the another instrument is called as a trisphere. Basically, this is the trisphere which will be have to measure the right angle of this any two surfaces. So, we'll suppose this is the workpiece. Okay. This is the workpiece. And we can measure the right angle. This is the main aim is to write. Just hold 1 meter. Everything is done. We will have. They can do it. We have to send kar dete. Google GG. How is it? Huh? No, no, no. Yeah, no. फाइल्स को भेज देता ठीक है ठीक है ठीक हमने स्टार्ट कर दिया हाँ ठीक है सो So what is that? We have interpreted that up here, okay? So in this particular cases, we have used the trisphere. Trisphere actually made with the two bodies. One is called as a blade and another is called as a stroke. The stroke and the blade which will be put inside this stroke, okay? Which will be put in the riveted and the, or you have used the screw to tighten the blade, okay? In the, these two bodies which will be made in a steel, cast steel which will be have used. Actually, basically the steel blade which will be used by the steel blade basically we are used, but the stroke which will be used by the cast iron. Okay, and here which will be have provided the brass plate which will be have to minimize the failure of this particular black blade. Okay, the size usually varies from 150 to 300 millimeter according to the length of the blade. Then this is the working that we have used. That this is the one of this workpiece body, and we have put it here. The stroke which will be put in this particular surface, and the blade which will be here, and we just draw a 90 degree line. So that is we have checked that this line which will be have 90. Basically, we have checked the edges of this particular point. This is the check. This particular point we have to check it. That this line which will be have these two lines which will have 90 degree or not. These two have put it as a 90 degree. So that is actually we have checking in particular this instrument is called as a trisphere. Trisphere is a very important instrument for the workshop. Okay, so that the most of the cases are we have used the trisphere to check the 90 degree of this particular body. Suppose here is the workpiece, we just check it that this face and this face which will be have perpendicular to each other or not. This is the perpendicular direction of this two work. Okay, now come to the vernier height gauge. So this is the same things which will be have vernier caliper, but this is a vertical things which will be have provided. So this is the base which will be have is a very high mass which will be provided here to stand the vertical directions. Okay, and the accuracy which will be have 0.02 mm. So that is actually we have put in the list count of this particular gauge. Okay, and here which will be have two lines which will be have one side which will be have meter scale or centimeter and millimeter scale, and other side which will be have inch scale. I just this is the knob which will be have used for this particular measurement. Okay, so that is called as a vernier height gauge. Now this is a very important measuring instrument in the workshop. It is called as a micrometer. Okay, the micrometer is an instrument to design that designed to take very precise measurement when you done. So that is called as a, then we are use the micrometer. Okay. So basically, which are we are using the screws, pipes, valves, and the tools. That is, we have this type of instrument which will be used for this to measure the dimension of this to the use of this micrometer. Okay. But generally, micrometer are used to people who are need to exactly, exactly accurate dimension which will be have measured. That means the accurate. If you have one to measure the accurate dimension, then we are used as a micrometer. Okay. So here in the micrometer, which will be have. So this is this part which will be called as a body of this micrometer. Okay, this is also called as a frame, and this part which will be anvil, and this is called as a spindle. So the spindle which will we have moved up and this side and this side. So this is the movement of the spindle. Okay, this is the movement of the spindle which will we have. According to that, this knob which will we have move another. Suppose we have provided is one of the cylindrical body. Just which will be move it in the clockwise direction, then it is a this particular spindle is moved to the left side. Okay, and this is a tightened by this ratchet screw. Okay, and we have to calculate the least count of this micrometer. How it is calculated? That the least count which will we have calculated by the P by N. What is P? P is called a pitch diameter for the mean smaller distance of the main scale. So this is called as the main scale dimension, and this is called as the total division of the circular scale. Okay, so the how it is calculated by pitch scale, that this is the total division: 1 millimeter, 2 millimeter, 3, 4, and 5 millimeter. And so between these two line, which will be this is the 1 millimeter distance, and this between the two lines, the middle which will have one of that particular line. So that is that's why it is the division which will have 0.5. Okay, and total number of division which will be for the circular scale, I just show you here also, that this is the 45 division, then this is the 0 which will come to this 45, 46, 47, 48, 49. So total marking which will be 45, so division which will be 50. So that is the 50 division. So that is the total number of divisions of the circular scale. Okay, so that is coming out as a 0.01 least count. So this type of instrument which will be basically used for the precise measurement of the any kind of job. Okay, so the least count is also right in this here. So this was 0.01 millimeter. Okay. Now we come to the marking tools. There we have different marking tools used in the workshop. We have total 6 number of marking tools which will be used in the whole of the workshop. Basically, we are discuss about the fittings of also. That fittings of we are use different types of marking tools. Here which will we have scriber, then punch, then the other another marking tool which will we have V block, then angle plates also, and tri square, and the last one is called Jennifer caliper. Just hold 1 minute. All of the students are hold 1 minute. KWQ. जी ऑल अरे एडमिट करेंगे तब ना ज्वाइन होगा अब हम तो पढ़ाने चालू कर दिए हम देखे ही नहीं आ गया ठीक है चलो ओके तो कहीं स्क्रीन इज विजिबल
यस ऑल ऑफ यू
यस विजिबल सर
ओके ओके सो वी कैन कंटिन्यू So there is a total 6 number of marking tools are we use in the workshop. So that is the first one is called as a scriber. So that is actually basically called as a scriber. Scriber is a piece of hardened steel about 150 to 300 millimeter length. So the length is about 150 to 300 millimeter, and the diameter is basically what you use for normal cases, which is 3 to 5 millimeter in diameter. Pointed one place, this is the one pointed, and sometimes this is both the pointed which will be used for this particular scriber. It is a one type of we call as a pencil type that where we have just described the metal on this particular workpiece. Okay, just I showed you that. Suppose we have a suppose this is the workpiece. Okay, I want to draw a line from this horizontal line. So that means I just put it here in this particular point. I just scribe it from here to here. So that is then the metal which will be scribe on this particular places. So that is that's why we use this call as a marking tool. Okay. So that is the why it is bend in one side, because sometimes it will be have not straight line which will be not provided, but some edge line which we have provided. That's why we are using this particular bend type of scribe. Okay. Now punches. We have punch basically to mark on this particular surface of the workpiece. Okay. So here we have two types of punches we are basically use. One is called as a pick punch, another is called as a center punch. The pick punch is basically the sharpness as compared to the center punch. Because pitch punch which will be have angle which will be around 40 degree between these two, and here the center punch which will be used for 60 degree or 90 degree. Okay. So basically we are used for the punching of this particular surface of the body. Suppose we have to want to, suppose we have a drill in this particular point, just we have in this particular measuring the dimension distance from here to here, and just take it as a pitch punch here and just strike it. So we have a edge which will be have formation on this particular points. Okay. And after the pick punch, we are used for the center punch to enlarge this particular dimension. Okay. Here in this particular point, we are used for the center punch. Okay. So that is actually basically we are used for the punching of this particular point. So before the we have can drill, we have just marking this particular point to use by this punch. Okay. So there are so many punches we are used. There's a center punch, prick punch, then starting line punch, then pin punch, then aligning punch. There's so many punches we are used for the different work in the workshop. Okay. Now V block. V block is also used called as a holding tools for is called as also the call for marking tools we are used in the workshop. So basically we are putting in the this type of cases that we are putting the cylindrical body in this particular point here. We just put in here in the cylindrical body. This place is okay, and hold it under one of this particular holder. We just hold it here, and we just lock in this particular point. Okay, here we have this lock it. This is the place we have to put as a locking purposes, and we just whatever that we are working, which will be done in this particular after putting in this particular cylindrical body in the, on the V block, and we are working on it. Okay, so basically there are different shape of V block we are used. The length is from 50 to 200 millimeter width, and the height is 50 to 100 millimeter. So that is the width of this particular V block, which will be used for this particular purposes. That is the width of that, and the height which will be have 50 to 100 millimeter. Okay. Translate is also called as a holding devices. We have a particular range of this particular any kind of machine. Suppose this is a machine, and this is called as a angle plate. And this angle plate, which will be put it here in this particular point, which will we have just bolted. We have taken a bolt, and we have this particular this work job, which will we have fixed in this particular angle plate. Okay, so this is actually basically the holding device, as well as all you have called it as a measuring marking device. Also, this particular or any kind of work, this one. Okay. So this is a conjunction with the surface plate for the supporting work for the perpendicular position. So we have basically these are two pieces which will be have perpendicular to each other. Okay, and there are different places we have cut a slot to tighten the workpiece by this bolt or nut, whatever that we are used in this particular purpose. Okay, so any students which will be have present, I'll just show you. Okay. So now next is a Jenny caliper. Jenny caliper is the same which will be have used in the previously we are used in the caliper also, but here we have there is some difference which will be have from the caliper inside or outside caliper to the Jenny caliper. The Jenny caliper which will be one leg which will be straight and the bend in this particular point, and one side which will be have one is a hole in the pin. Okay, in just particular point which will be have pin which will be fixed. Okay. And this one is sometimes this one is adjustable, that the pin which will move inside or outside. Okay. And we have to measure this way, that one side which will be where the one leg which will be put in this particular edges, and we have draw the straight parallel line from the edges. So you have to draw this one. So this is the use for this particular marking tools for this particular any kind of work which will be have done in the parallel lines or any type of lines which will be have draw. Suppose we have to cut draw in this particular lines, then we have to put in a Jenny calipers also. Okay. There is a two, basically this legs which will be made by the steels. Okay, and here is also have one type of Jenny calipers which will be have the spring connection. So normal spring, the fixed Jenny calipers and the spring connection Jenny calipers we are used basically in the workshop. Then the striking tools. There are so many striking tools that are used in the workshop. So one of that is called as the hammer. Okay, so hammer is basically is a, one of the main striking tool in used in the workshop. So it is made of a forged steel for various sizes. So the sizes basically depends upon the weight of the body and the shape of this particular pin. Okay. And this is actually basically PWM pin. Okay. A suitable range which will be from 0.11 to 0.33 kg from the lightweight one. So when you the work which is basically lightweight, so lightweight means you have a hammer is a plastic body or some very nylon type of bodies, then we are used as basically we use very lightweight of striking tool. Okay, and for on some different work purposes, it's called as a chilling small rivets, we also use for the small type of striking tool, and 0.45 kg for the chilling purposes, and for the 91 kg which is the heavier work which will be have used for this particular hammer. Okay. But the general purposes we are used for this particular hammer is basically used for the 0.33 to 0.45 kg. Okay. The hammer consists of the four parts. One is called as a pin, then another is called as a head. So that is called as a head and eye. This part which is basically called as the eye, and this is called as a face. Eye is normally made of oval and elliptical in shape. So this is portion which will be called as the eye. It is made of sometimes it is basically which will be cut in a elliptical shape or oval shape. Okay, and this particular points we actually put the handle of this particular here according to the size of this or the shape of the eye which will we have put in the handle. Okay, the handle which will be made of the wood or the bamboo. Okay, the face of the hardened coal polished oil, and it is slightly convex type of that. So this is the face which will we have basically which will we have some have convex type of shape which will be have provided. Okay, and the handle should be is a 250 to 325 millimeter long. Okay, the different types of hammer we are normally used. Yep, so in a total seven types of hammer we are used. That is called as a claw hammer, then another ball pin hammer, cross pin hammer, then straight pin hammer, then chipping hammer, then sledge hammer, and the soft hammer that is called also mallet. Okay. So that the total seven types of hammer we are normally used. I can told you that different type. So this is called as a clay hammer. So clay hammer basically used for the suppose we have a one of the nail in the surface, and just with the filling of the nail from the surface, then we are using this particular point. Okay, just put it here, nail. I just take the nail here and just put it. So this is the two purposes which we have. This particular hammer, if you have a hit this particular point or you have a filling these nails from the surface, then it is used for the claw hammer. Okay, so in the same things which will be claw hammer, this is called as a face, this is this particular point is called as a eye, this is head, this particular head, and this is called as a pin. Okay, and this is called as a handle or called as a, also the handling purposes of this particular work. Okay. Now another hammer which will be called as a ball hammer. So ball pin hammer, that means it will be the head of this particular as a ball type of shape. So that's why it is called as a ball pin hammer. And this hammer basically used most of the engineering work. So that's why it is called as a engineer's hammers also. Okay. The shape of the ball is hardened and the pulley. So this is after the hammer which will be manufactured, then we have to put in the heat treatment process to harden this particular core surface of this particular hammer. Okay, and the size of the hammer is varies from 0.1 to 0.91 kg. Okay, Now this is a cross pin hammer, so this is also one type of hammer we are used in the workshop, and this is basically the pin which will be have perpendicular to the surface, perpendicular to the axis. So this is the axis of the hammer. Okay, this is the axis, and this is called as a perpendicular. So this is the perpendicular to the axis. So this is the axis, and this hammer which will be have perpendicular to that. The pin which will be have perpendicular to the. So that is why I say cross pin hammer. Okay. So the size which will be have 0.22 to 0.91 kg. Okay. Now this is called as a straight pin hammer. The straight pin hammer, the pin which will be have parallel to the axis of the hammer. So this is the axis which I have already told you that this is the axis of this hammer. Okay. And this pin which will be have parallel to the handle. So that is this called as a straight pin hammer. Okay. This is also the hammer which will be have. There is a different size of hammer which will be used for this particular any kind of different work purposes. So the weight which will be varies from 0.11 to 0.91 kg. Okay. Now the chipping hammer which will be have the both side which will be have same shape, but which will be have different orientation. This one which will be have parallel to the axis, and this side will be have the perpendicular to the axis, which will be have used for the chipping purposes. Okay. And this hammer basically used in the welding shop. This is not in the fitting shop. So actually, this is the hammer actually basically used for the suppose when there are some impurities after welding or casting. So there is some old impurities which will be present. Suppose in this particular point, so this is and this part which will be have hammerized chipping this particular surface of this particular workpiece. So that's why we, this type of hammer basically used for the casting and the welding saw. The sledgehammer basically used for the large type of work. Okay, so when you heavy work which will be have that when cutting is a heavy metal, heavy thick metal, or you use as a for a heavy body which will be have suppose one of the nail which will be have put in the surface of this body, and then we have hammering on this particular use of this particular hammer. So that is called as a sledgehammer. Now the soft hammer is basically used for the mallet. It is also called as a mallet. Okay, this hammer is basically used in the carpentry shop. That is a very soft type of that, and both the surfaces we are striking on this particular workpiece. So that is called as a, basically this is not called as a soft hammer. This is called as a mallet. So you have always called it. This is called as a mallet. Okay. The cutting tools. Cutting tools. One of the cutting tools. There are so many cutting tools are used in the fitting shop. So one of these called as a chisel,
then file, then saws, then a scriber, and the grinding and the polishing. Now we are using a chisel. The chisel is basically used for the cutting to cutting purposes of this workpiece. Okay, and it is we also called as a chipping of the surface of this body. Okay, the chisels are made of the carbon steel, usually as a rectangular shape, then hexagonal shape or orthogonal cross-sectional shape. So this shape which will be have basically called as a cutting tool of this particular chisel. Okay. After making the chisel. Yes.
Hello. Yes. Sir, can you please show the sixth hammer that you have just reclassified? Just a second.
A sledge hammer. This is called as a sledge.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Very heavy work which will be used. Okay. So for striking the
okay, sir.
Yes, is very very hard. Then we are used basically the, this also this hammer is basically also used on a structural purposes. Okay. So in this chisel, this is there is a so many parts which will be have. This part which will be have called as a cutting part. Okay. So that is as a cutting bevel. This is called as a hill. Okay. This is the side part of this particular chisel, and this part which will be called as a shoulder. Then here it is called as a nick, and this is called as a bolster and fuel. This part which will be called as a shoulder, and this tang which will be put inside the handle. So this is the tang which will be put inside this handle. Okay, and this is the cutting part of this particular chisel, and the angle which will be varies from 35 to 70 degrees. Okay. So here which will be have there is a three part main three parts of the chisel which will be have the cutting edge part. This is the cutting part. Then the sang part. This is called as a sang part, and this is called as a head part. Okay.
So there are different types of chisel we are we use in the workshop. There are total 5 types of chisel we are using in the workshop, that is called as a flat chisel, then cross cut chisel, then half round chisel, then diamond point chisel, and the side chisel. I'll just show you that. This is called as a flat chisel. So flat chisel is most commonly used, all the chisel used in the engineering workshop. So workshop, most of the this type of chisel usually basically used in the workshop. Okay. This type of chisel used for the most of the general purposes also.
Okay. Basically used for the cutting of the metals and remove of the surplus metal from the job. Okay. The length of the flat chisel is varies from 100 to 400 millimeters. So this is basically the length which will we have varies from the chisel. It will be length which will we have 100 to 400 millimeters. And width of the cutting tool, this part which will we have, cutting edge, which will be 16 to 32 millimeters. Okay. So that is actually basically we are used in the cutting edge. The cutting edge which will be varies from 60 to 32 millimeters of this particular flat chisel. The next chisel is called as a cross cut chisel. This is also another type of chisel we are used for the cutting purposes. There is a specific work on this particular cutting this type of chisel which will be used. Okay. The length of the chisel is same thing, which will be have 100 to 400 millimeters, and the cutting edge is very low. This is around 4 to 12 mm as compared to the flat chisel, which is around 16 to 32 mm. Okay. Another chisel is called as a half round chisel. So this part which will be have the which will be have half rounded. The chisel which will be have half rounded. Okay. So that is what there is a specific purpose. Suppose we have a hole. Suppose there is a hole. And just put in a circular of this particular hole. So I just cut it here. So cut the material which will be removed from that. And so that's why we use this type of half round chisel. Okay. Just like this, for this part which will be removed from the workpiece. Okay. Previously, suppose we have a previously cut the suppose there is also another, suppose this part which will be half cut in this particular square shape, and we put it in a circle. Just put it in a circle inside of this particular square. So that is what we are used for the half round chisel. The length which will we have, same things, almost same length which will we have, 150 to 200 millimeters, but the cutting edge which will we have 2 to 16 millimeters. Then another chisel which will be used in the workshop is called as a diamond point chisel. The shape of this particular point which will we have, shape in a diamond shape. So that is actually basically we are used for the specific purposes of this particular chisel which will be used. So this is a one type of job which we have put in a 90 degree angle. This is the angle, and we have some part which we have removed from this particular edge. Then we are used as a diamond type of chisel. Okay. And this chisel which we have length which is almost same, that 400 to 100 to 400 mm, and width is varies from the 6 to 16 mm. Okay. And the last chisel which we have, the side chisel. The side chisel which will be shaped in this pattern. This the side which will have, one side is large and another side is called as a small. I will just cut in this particular point of a body which will have is this chisel is particularly useful for chipping purposes or remove the surplus material from the material. So that is it is also cutting as a slot cutting. So you cut as a slot, then we use as a right chisel. Okay. So today we stop the discussion, and now we come to the workshop. Any doubt about that? Anyone any doubt about the instrument? Hello.
No sir, no doubt.
Okay, then. Fire sir.
Hello.
Okay. Yes sir.
Are you ready? Okay. I just before you start, this is the index page. Okay, so this is the index page. We have formed this particular index page. All of you have visible on this particular. Hello.
Yes, sir. It is visible.
Okay, that is okay. So you write your name also here, then your department is IT, so you just write here IT, then batch, if your batch is F1, then you write your university roll number and the semester is first. Okay. So this is the serial number we have provided. This is the this column which we have a serial number. Suppose we have a one job, this is the serial number, you just suppose this is the one job you have a fitting, suppose this is the one job, you just write as a one. Then job number you also put, we have give the job numbers, the name of the jobs, whatever the jobs you have done in the workshop, there is a name, there is a specific name is that. So you just write is a specific name, then date of performance, what is the date which we have performed this particular date, so this is write is a date, and which date you have to submit, so the date of submission. Okay. So that is this two part which we have for the particular hours. Okay. Now the second part, actually, this is the front page of this particular you whatever the make you have a file. This is the front page of this particular workshop file. So this is you write your name. Here there is the two names which you have. There is some university roll numbers, then a date of experiment. Just write it here, date of submission. Then that is actually basically the front page of this particular job. For the particular any job, suppose we have a job in the fitting shop, or if you have a job in the welding shop, a job in the machine shop, then you just whatever the right you have just put in this particular front page. After the front page, you have continue on the other pages also, attach on the other pages. Okay, so the date of experiment you write in, date of submission, then title of the job, the job numbers, and the co-workers here, because in this particular cases we have a there is no any co-workers because you have online classes, so you just write your only serial number and name and the roll number. Okay. Now, one thing I just show you that because this is
file, sir. Hello.
Yes, sir.
हमारा pen नहीं on हो रहा है इसमें. इसमें pen नहीं on हो रहा है.
अच्छा. ठीक है मैं.
Sharing में.
इसका pen नहीं देखिए ना ये cursor दिखा रहा है. Pen नहीं आ रहा है.
Pen आ ही नहीं रहा.
हाँ pen नहीं आ रहा है इसमें. तो इसको आपके पास वो ये पीपीटी में दिया हुआ है ये देखिए तो
मेरे पास है यहाँ हम शेयर कर देंगे
हाँ नहीं मतलब वो तो शेयर इसको एक बार डायग्राम के यहाँ बनाने पड़ेगा ना एक बार चार हम बना दीजिए तो एक एक काम करिए ना ये यहाँ एक रेक्टेंगुलर बनाइए ठीक है
अच्छा
मैं आपको बता देता हूँ यहाँ पर एक रेक्टेंगुलर बनाइए इसमें 116 दीजिए और यहाँ पर ये 50 दीजिए एंड आपका वो ये एक थोड़ा सा पतला सा एक बना दीजिए यहाँ पर ऐसे उसको 6 कर दीजिए और लेंथ में 50 कर दीजिए ओके उसके बाद ये जो आपका जॉब है आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू दैट दिस इज द योर फिटिंग जॉब एक्चुअली वी हैव प्रोवाइडेड यू ओके द एम ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर फिजिंग आर व्हाट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर जॉब टू प्रिपेयर ए मेल और एंड फीमेल सेक्शन यूजिंग द एमएस प्लेट माइल स्टील प्लेट एंड प्रॉपर असेंबल ऑफ द देम सो वी हैव टू पीसेस ऑफ दिस बॉडी So this pieces of the body initially we have provided as a 116 length 50 width and 6 mm mild steel plate okay the metal plate we have provided to you that is the dimension which will be okay this is the three dimension which will be provided and from that three dimension we have to make this particular type which will be have here so this is have a one part and this is the another part
hello ha sir
तो मेरा ये नहीं आ रहा है पेन नहीं आ रहा है okay. आप थोड़ा सा ठीक है अब मैं शेयर कर देता हूँ आप थोड़ा सा बता दीजिए इसको
ठीक है नेक्स्ट टाइम से मैं इसको पीपीटी में डालने पड़ेगा तभी आएगा ठीक है मैं स्टॉप कर रहा हूँ आप थोड़ा सा कंटिन्यू करिए हाँ ओके यू कंटिन्यू योर
है ना वहाँ पे
Students, any questions about that? Anyone, any queries about that workshop? That there is a different tools we are using in the workshop. There is any questions about your? Hello. Any questions from your side? Anyone? All of you write this one actually, right or not? Hello. Saurabh Singh?
Yes, sir.
There is any questions about from your side?
No, sir.
All are okay? There is any
yes,
doubt?
Sir, I think, no, sir, I don't have a doubt. I think all are clear. Okay. I have revised that and all are clear.
Okay, thick. Thank you. The fire, sir, is continued. Okay?
Okay. Okay, sir.
Sir, please stop sharing. My sir. Good afternoon, students.
जॉब सेट निकल दे मुझे वो पे निकल कर
स्टूडेंट्स गुड आफ्टरनून
Good afternoon, sir.
Okay, today I see the job number one, which is a preparation of male and female section. ऑफ करो तुम देखा रहा जब तुझ स्टूडेंट्स
Visible issue.
question, students. The point is not appearing in this page. So I will show the job directly. Now see students, this job. Students, are you seeing the dimension? Can you tell me the dimension, students? Please, anyone? Given, sir. Students. Sanchan.
Sir, 54:48.
54.
Versus 48.
81, sir.
54:81.
Oh, 81.
Sorry, sir.
81. Okay, see, material required. Are you seeing 160 mm? 16. And into 50 mm, into 6 mm. Now see, 160 mm is the length of the total job, means two pieces of job. Okay, and 50 mm is the width. And 6 mm is the thickness. Okay, students. You can see this is the job piece. Are you seeing in my video? Students, are you seeing? Students, are you seeing?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is job piece made of mild steel. MS, okay. Now see, this length is 116 mm. And this width is 50 mm. And this thickness is 6 mm. Okay, students. So first of all, see, I'll file this portion. Okay. This portion and this portion. I have to make it 90 degrees with the help of file. Okay. Then I will check it with the help of okay, so after that I will check after making 90 degrees. I'll rub the check on the metal piece and then I cut it. Sorry, I will mark 54 mm in the PPT or CRT screen. There is 27 plus 27 means 54 mm. So first I have to cut 54 mm. Okay, of two pieces. Okay, sir. And then I will again make it 90 degrees in both sides. Okay. Also, the practical video. Please wait 5 minutes. Practical video. See, students, this is all your job. Okay, this one is male portion and this is female section. Okay, you have to make like this. and C is a hole where written half inch BSW thread. Questions. Half inch BSW thread. BSW means British standard width worth. This is the standard size of bed. This is rough blade, rough thread. BSW thread is the rough thread. In this hose, we have to measure tab thread size. This hole will be less than the tab size. Yes. Now, see what instrument I will use for this job. See, press use steel rule. It will see steel rules. Please give response. Students, you see steel rule. Abhijit, please give response.
Yes, sir.
हाँ बोला अभिजीत. Have you seen steel rule?
Yes, sir.
What is the least count of steel rule in mm?
Sir, 0.1 mm.
No.
Sir, 1 mm, sir.
0.02 mm.
That is for Vernier caliper. 0.02 mm.
Sir, 1 mm.
No, for lab it's 0.02.
Okay, this is 0.5 mm. We can measure 0.5 mm in mm and in inch. Do you know? Students, what is the least count of steel in inch? Anjan?
Yes, sir.
इसकोन कितना है स्टील का इंच में मिलीमीटर में बता दिए ना कितना मिलीमीटर में कंचन मिलीमीटर में बोलो गिव रिस्पांस कंचन
सर सर योर वॉइस इज लैगिंग कुड नॉट सर 0.25
नहीं इंच
0.25 inch.
Listen, the least count of steel in inch 1/64. Okay, 64 division 1 inch. So it is called 1/64 inch. We can measure this unit. Okay, student. What material is made of steel? Student, what material is made of steel wool?
Hello, anyone can tell which material is made of steel rule? Hello.
Okay, students, see. I'll use, sir, I have already got the apparatus. Okay, then I'll start the video. Please wait 5 minutes.
फायज सर आपका वॉइस नहीं आ रहा है। हेलो फायज सर आपका वॉइस नहीं आ रहा है।
नहीं नहीं बोल रहे हैं, अभी वीडियो तो हम शेयर कर रहे हैं, उसके बाद बोलूंगा, अभी म्यूट कर रहा हूँ मैं। Students, can you tell me what is fitting? Students,
students, what is fitting?
Sir, a small portion of any object.
Yeah. What, repeat.
Sir, any small portion of any object, like wooden object or any object.
Definition is not clear. Fitting, what is fitting? What do you mean by fitting? Abhijit, sir? Abhishek? Arjit Bandopadhyay? What is fitting?
Sir, can I tell?
No, see that?
Yes,
you can. You can.
Sir, fitting means, sir, matching part to touch or join each other in such a way that one will turn inside and other, and another one will slide up to another, or the parts hold tightly together.
Yes, fine. Okay students, I'm sharing the practical video. Good, big sir. Now see, are you seeing students?
These
are
the two.
Yes.
This one is offset caliper. This is measuring instrument. This is a divider. Marking paper, marking and transfer instrument. This is a scriber, marking instrument. This one is punch, also marking instrument.
Student, is it visible or not? Student, visible?
Yes, sir, visible.
Okay, okay. Okay, continue. Continue, see the video. Okay.
See, this is number punch. This is roll number marking, and this one is letter punch, which is also marking instruments. Now see, this is tri square, checking and measuring instrument. See, these are cutting tools. This one is hacksaw. This is cutting instrument.
Sir, voice is very low.
This is also cutting instrument. These are taps. This is cutting instrument. This is tap wrench, which is used to hold the tap. And see, these are files. These are cutting instruments. Different types of file are there. This is a grass cut file. This one is triangular file. This is a round file. This one is flat file, and this is also flat file. Okay, students. and this is hammer. This one is striking instruments. And now see, this is combination set. There are four pieces. This one is this one is a scale, and this one is bevel protector. This is center gauge, and this is 45 degree angle and 90 degree angle measuring attachment. Okay, sir. So these are called combination set. Now I am starting the job, students. I hope that you know the title of the job. Can you tell me the title of the job, students? Students, can you tell me the title of the job?
Fitting.
Students, get response. Do you know the title of the job?
Fitting. Fitting.
Now see, this is our job sheet. Title of the job, preparation of a male and female section on metal plate. Okay, students, and this is our job piece. This is male part and this one is female part. Okay, now see practically. See, this is female part. Okay, this is female part and this one is male part. You have to make like this. Okay, and you have to join like this. Okay, students, see, just like this. This one is this and this one is this. You have to join like this. Okay, students, and this is threading portion. Okay, now I'll start the job. See, this is our job piece made of mild steel. Students, you have to remember the material. What material is made of job piece?
Mild steel.
Give response, students.
Mild steel.
कौन सा material है? I have already told you. Yes, mild steel.
Mild steel.
Okay. Now see what you have to do first. First, you'll measure your job piece. Is it given? Is it given according to the required or not? Okay. See, this is 116 mm. Suppose this is 116 mm. Okay. So first of all, you have to make 90 degree. Okay. So making 90 degree, first you have to check it. See, this one is, do you know the name of these tools, students? Students, do you know the name of these tools?
Tri square.
What is this? This is tri square, okay? The tri square is used for checking squareness, flatness, 90 degree angle and lay out the workpiece. Okay. Okay, now I will check the job, is it 90 degree or not. Okay, see the light is passing. Okay, students, see, the light is passing from here and here is touching the blade. So we have to file in this portion first. Okay, now I'm holding it. Before starting the filing, I have to show some methods of filing. Okay, students, now see the methods of filing.
There are three methods of filing. Straight filing. See, the teeth of the file is the backward of the operator, okay, that side. So you have to pressure forward direction. Like this. This is known as straight filing. During straight filing, the particular material will be removed. And when we will remove the metal from the whole area, then we have to adapt cross filing. See, this is cross filing. During cross filing, we have removed whole area metal. This is cross filing. When I will give the finish, then I have to adapt draw filing. See, this is draw filing. During draw filing, we have to give both side force. We'll give the force both side, forward direction, backward direction. Okay. This is draw filing. So I am making it 90 degree. So we have to file in the particular area. We have to adapt straight filing. Okay, now I will adapt cross filing. Now I will check the job piece. Is it? Degree or not? No, see. See. It became 90 degree. Okay, students. Now, after making this side, I have to adapt same process in the opposite side. Okay. I'll check this side also and I have to make 90 degree this side also. See, it is approximately 90 degree. Okay, so there is no need to file in this side. Okay, now but so I am filing little more. This side is touching. Okay. Now I am finishing. Now see, student, there is burst. This is the cause of accident. So we have to remove this burst, okay? This is sharp. So we have to remove these chips or burst. Okay, students. Now the first process was to make 90 degree both sides. And now I have to take 54 mm according to the figure. Okay, so for taking 54 mm, first I will rub the chalk on the metal piece so that our marking will be clear. Okay, students, now I will take 54 mm length. See, I can take direct 54 mm length with the steel rule like this, and I will use a scriber. Okay, students, I am using a scriber now. Now see, student, this is tri-scribe. From marking, this operation is known as layout, okay? Now I am marking it like this. Okay, see, the line is visible now. We can also mark with the help of Jenny caliper, okay, students? Now see, how will you mark? This is Jenny caliper. You will take 54 mm length from the steel rule. Okay, and now I will mark it like this. Okay, students. Okay, after marking 54 mm, I will cut it with the help of hacksaw blade. Okay, before cutting, I have to hold the job. So where will hold the job? See, this is bench vise. Student, this is bench vise. Bench vise is used for holding the job while cutting, thread cutting, a parting of filing. Now see, before, see, this is 54 mm length. Now I have to cut this job piece from outside of the line. Okay, not on the line. Okay, so now see, this is hacksaw blade. Sorry, hacksaw frame. This is fixed type hacksaw frame. There is no adjustable parts. So this is called fixed frame hacksaw. Now I will start the cutting. Before starting the cutting, I have to keep the nail for supporting the blade so that it not move. Now I am starting cutting. See, for cutting the metal, I have to give pressure forward direction. Okay, like this, because the teeth of the blade is forward. Now see students, this is not exact 90 degree, so we have to make 90 degree, this side also. Okay, so the light is passing, so I have to make it 90 degree with the help of file. The bar or chips. Now it is finished. This turn, it is exact 90 degree now. Now first I will prepare female part. Female part, see, same, first I have to rub the chalk on the metal piece.
and now I can adopt same operation, so I will divide this line in equal part. See, I am getting middle point like this. See, this is exact middle point. Also, I have to adapt the other process for getting middle point like this. So, see, this is 54 mm. So, I have to take 27 mm. Okay, this is 27 mm. Now, students, you know very well that the see, this is the angle which is given here, which is 90 degree angle. Okay, students, are you seeing? This angle is 90 degree and the height is 15 mm. See, the height is 15 mm. So, can you tell me how much distance I have to take from here to here? So, first, see, this is 15 mm. I'll take 15 mm. I can use tri square, Jenny caliper. See, students, I am taking 15 mm. See, now I will mark 15 mm. Okay, students, see, 15 mm, this marking. I have to mark like this. Students, we can draw the layout both, means male or female. But first I have to draw female part. Okay, so we will take, see, this is bevel protractor, bevel protractor or combination set. I will see, the angle is already given. I will take this angle, means this is the perpendicular. So I can take 45 mm like this. This is 45 degree. See, there is 45 degree. 45. This is meeting with zero initial line. Okay. Now I'll take 45 mm. Either like this, I can mark either like this or according to the Pythagoras theorem, I can take, see, this is 15 mm distance, so it will be also 15 mm from the middle. Okay, 15 mm from the middle. So I'll take direct 15 mm. We can adapt both process. See, I'll take 15 mm from the middle. And see, from here 5, 10, 15. See, these 2 points. Now, this is not clear. So, I will mark again. I have 10, 15. Okay, then, see, this is the point. I can put the tri square like this. Okay, students, and now I will mark with the help of a scriber.
students, see, there is a mirror. Okay, and also I mark from this side. Sorry. This is male part. Students, I am telling you that this will be female part, but it is preparing male part. Okay, students. If I will take from this point and I will join here, then it will be the female part. Okay. Now this is male part. See, this is not permanent marking. It may be erased if I will keep the hands here. So for permanent marking, I have to punch on the line with the help of break punch. See, this is break punch and this one is hammer. And now I will keep the job piece on the anvil. Let us see, students, where is the anvil? See, students, this one is anvil. Anvil is used for supporting the job while it's tracking. Okay, now see, this is the our line. Now I will mark. This is for permanent marking. Okay, students. I will take this 10, 2 or 3 mm.
Hello. See the next video, student.
So Faisal is making punching operation.
Okay, students. This is permanent punching operation. This operation is used for marking permanent line. See, now this line will not be erased easily. Now see, I am removing the chalk. Please, students. Now see, I have already removed the chalk and I will just rub the chalk on the punching portion. Now you can see the line clearly. Students, are you seeing the line? Give response. This is permanent marking. Okay, students. Now I will cut it, this portion. Okay, this is male section. Okay, now see how I will cut it. I have to hold the job on the bench wise. this student, see, I am holding it. When I will hold the job, then I will rotate the handle clockwise direction. Okay? Now see, for cutting the job, I have to start the job from the outside of the line, not on the line, okay?
Okay, student, cutting, start of cutting of the job piece. Student, again open the job and other side cutting of the job. First one is 90 degree here. Hold the job again and cutting the job. Hold again and check 90 degree. Check 90 degree, okay. Okay. Now we start. Again 90 degree of cut, okay, meter. Another side cutting 90 degree. Check perfect 90 degree. Okay. Again start cutting of the job.
keep this like this parallel to the vice. Now I will erupting filing operation. Now I will also file this portion of students, so I have to keep like this. Now my part is already completed. Okay, students, see, this is male part. Okay, now I'll prepare female part. See, this is the same job pieces. Okay, same process I have to add up. First, I have to make it 90 degree both sides. Students, can you tell me what are the methods of filing? Students, give response. What?
So straight, cross,
this is loudly.
And
yes.
And sideways, sir.
Straight filing, cross filing, and draw filing, okay? You have to remember it, okay? Don't forget it.
File, sir.
Boliye, sir.
Bola, aaj ke logo ko female part bataoge na next time mein? Aaj hi bataoge na next class mein?
Aap jaisa boliyega waisa karenge.
Next class mein, kyunki wo time pe hoga nahi. Already time is there, already over.
To male part tab dikha denge, female part next class mein dikhayenge.
Next class mein, haan, next class mein. ठीक है,
ठीक है ना सर?
हाँ ठीक है, ठीक है, ठीक है, ठीक है, हाँ
हेलो.
सो स्टूडेंट, हाँ हाँ ठीक है, ठीक है सर, ठीक है, कोई बात नहीं.
अगले क्लास में?
हाँ अगले क्लास में, क्योंकि इसमें अभी हो टाइम नहीं, हो पाए, हो नहीं पाएगा. कर पाओगे क्या? नहीं हो पाएगा ना.
नहीं, अगले क्लास में दिखा दें तो ठीक है. कुछ क्वेश्चन है, हम लोग से पूछ लेते हैं स्टूडेंट.
हाँ 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 हाँ, वही है, वही वही मैं कह रहा हूँ. ठीक,
students, are you listening? Students, am I audible? Students,
yes sir.
Hello, hello.
हाँ सर,
ठीक है, बोलिए बोलिए बोलिए. All are
okay. Sir, what is the name of this tool?
What is the name of this tool?
Students, which I am using for checking.
Try square, sir.
Try square.
Good.
Try square, sir.
Can you tell me the parts of try square? What is the name of the parts which is I am holding in my right hand? Students, Arjit Bandopadhyay, jaldi bolo.
Stock, sir.
Kya? Stock, very good.
Stock.
Vishnu, what is the name of the parts which is parallel with the job piece? Vishnu?
विष्णु शर्मा, विष्णु शर्मा, हेलो विष्णु शर्मा,
Are you
Chanchal
present?
Mandal? Chanchal Mandal. Chanchal Mandal, what is the part? What is the name of this part?
Sir, ye log on karke na chale jaate. The problem hai ye.
हाँ सर भाई तो अभी कंचन लिफ्ट किया
चंचन मंडल चंचन मंडल हेलो चंचन मंडल
जय चक्रवर्ती जय चक्रवर्ती सर ब्लेड वेरी गुड कौन बोला
सर अभिजीत
अभिजीत जय चक्रवर्ती तुम लोग यहाँ पे प्रेजेंट हो जो पूछ रहे हैं वो कम से कम रिस्पांस दो Kanchan Sarkar, what is the metal which I am using for the job? What material is made of?
Sir, mild steel.
Mild steel. Okay.
And I will make, is that also mild steel?
Aritra Bosch. Aritra was, are you present?
Yes, sir.
What is the yes, name sir. Of the tool which is used for holding the workpiece?
What is this name? What is this name?
Sir,
Bolo? Aritra Bosch?
Sir, forgot.
Hello?
What?
Sir, I can't remember.
Manu Bhattacharji. Manu Bhattacharji. What is the name of tool which is used for holding the job piece or work piece? Manu Bhattacharji.
Manu is present. Hello. Manu Bhattacharji.
Oh. Nandani Pal. Nandani Pal. Sir, lift कर रहा है सब आस्ता आस्ता
हाँ जब आप पूछ रहे हैं तो सब lift कर रहा है
हाँ तो ऐसे कैसे चलेगा नहीं जानते कोई बात नहीं कम से कम रहो
हाँ.
शिल्पा प्रसाद शिल्पा प्रसाद
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What is the name of tool which is used for holding the job piece?
Sir, bench vise.
Good.
Very good. Can you tell me how will you specify a bench vise? Shilpa?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me how will you specify a bench vise? Yes, sir. Shivam, bolo.
Sir, width of the jaws, width of the jaws, we can specify the...
And?
Sir, and distance, sir, sir, distance between, sir, one, I forgot, sir.
Okay, that is a distance,
sir, distance between jaws.
Maximum opening.
Opening of the jaws.
Yeah, distance between jaws.
Maximum opening.
Opening of the jaws. These two jaws, which will be have open is a certain distance. So that is the maximum distance which will be open. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now ask him.
Sheila Bhattacharji. Sheila, are you listening? Sheila, am I audible?
Yes,
Sheila?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Name the parts of the vice, bench vice.
Sir, I forgot.
Sneha Sarkar. Sneha Sarkar. Name the parts of the vice. Name the parts of bench vice.
Sir, forgot.
Name of parts.
Sir.
Sir, can I tell? Bolo?
Yes.
Sir, moving jaw, fixed jaw.
Very good.
And then base.
What?
Sir, base.
Base. वेरी गुड
फिर सर वो हैंडल
हैंडल और स्क्रू
अच्छा
फिर स्क्रू
सनेहा
यस सर
व्हाट मटेरियल इज मेड ऑफ बेंच वाइस सनेहा व्हाट मटेरियल इज मेड ऑफ बेंच वाइस नहीं सनेहा को बोलने दो देखते हैं वो देख यहाँ पे रहती है या नहीं क्लास में नहीं रहेगी तो कैसे चलेगा सनेहा गिव
सर आई फॉरगॉट
यू फॉरगॉट और यू डोंट नो व्हिच रिंग यू हैव फॉरगॉट यू शो योर कॉपीज यू शो योर कॉपी व्हाट इफ यू राइट यू शो योर कॉपी
सनेहा कॉपी दिखाओ तो
शो योर कॉपी
चलो क्लिक कर कॉपी देखा कॉपी देखा सुने
सर कनेक्ट
सर कास्ट स्टील
हाँ बोलो बोलो जो बोलना है बोलो
कास्ट स्टील कास्ट स्टील
कास्ट स्टील
सर कास्ट स्टील
कास्ट स्टील
नॉट कास्ट स्टील
सर कास्ट आयरन
कास्ट आयरन सर
कास्ट आयरन स्नेहा तुम जो दिखा नहीं रहे हो क्या नोट्स की हो स्नेहा सर का तुम दिखाओ नोट्स का
आई कैन चेक ऑल ऑफ योर नोट्स इन द कमिंग नेक्स्ट क्लास आई कैन चेक ऑल ऑफ योर नोट्स ओके बी केयरफुल आई कैन चेक ऑल ऑफ योर नोट्स
माय सर
हेलो
माय सर इन लोगों को जॉब शीट सेंड कर दीजिएगा तो टोटल जॉब शीट जो है सर इन लोगों को सेंड कर दीजिएगा जो आज का जॉब शीट है वो उसका क्वेश्चन का आंसर लोग लिख करके लाएगा प्लस जो प्रोसीड्यूर मेल पार्ट का है वो मेल पार्ट का प्रोसीड्यूर लिखेगा
वो वाला क्वेश्चन नहीं जो नेक्स्ट कौन
है सर
अरे बाबा यदि के सारा दिन ये करे यार चालू किया ना क्वेश्चन ले কত লেগে নিলে কত নিলে কত নিলে কত নিলে আচ্ছা কত নিলে আর সে ঠিক আছে কিন্তু পয়সা থাকে না কিন্তু কিনবো তো কিতে দেওয়া উচিত চার পাঁচ কেজি কেনা খাওয়ার জন্য যে দাদা নাও
স্টুডেন্টস अभिजीत साहब
यस सर
नीचे जाओ तो पैसे दिए ना
कैन यू टेल मी द टाइप ऑफ फाइल अकॉर्डिंग टू शेप व्हिच आई एम यूजिंग नाउ
सर वन इज स्ट्रेट फाइल ट्रायंगुलर फाइल सर
नो जस्ट यू हैव टू टेल द फाइल व्हिच आई एम यूजिंग नाउ सी इन द वीडियो
ना छुट्टी नहीं अभी काजी है कॉलेज है सर व्हाट
टाइप ऑफ फाइल इज दिस अकॉर्डिंग टू शेप अभिजीत शाह
सर स्ट्रेट फाइल
कैन यू टेल
सर स्ट्रेट फाइल नॉट श्योर सर
हाँ हाँ ठीक है
जन जाने
जाने ठीक है
सर एम आई ऑडिबल सर स्ट्रेट फाइल आई थिंक सर नॉट श्योर दो
बोलो कुछ बोलो अगर नहीं जानते हो तो बोलो
हेलो हेलो
तो बोलो
हेलो
बता सकूं अगर नहीं जानते
हेलो
नो देन आई विल रिपीट इट अभिजीत
हेलो सर हेलो हेलो
विष्णु शर्मा नहीं जानते हो कोई बात नहीं है मैं बताऊंगा लेकिन ये तो मैं देखूंगी तुम क्लास में क्या समझते हो कि नहीं कुछ डॉट होगा तो जरूर पूछोगे विष्णु विष्णु शर्मा गिव रिस्पॉन्स विक्रम कुमार पंडित
यस सर
विक्रम कुमार पंडित हाँ बोलो विष्णु कुछ बोल रहे
हेलो सर एम आई ऑडिबल
हाँ यस यू आर ऑडिबल
हेलो
हाँ बोलो बोलो अभिजीत सर बोलो
अभिजीत सर
अभिजीत बोलो 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 अभिजीत
सर हम सर स्ट्रेट फाइल आई थिंक सर नॉट श्योर Sir, I was telling the answer, but it was not, network was not working, sir, I think.
Achha.
ओके देखते हैं कौन बोल पाता है. चंचल मंडल, चंचल मंडल, व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस फाइल अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर शेप. चंचल मंडल, जय चक्रवर्ती.
यस सर.
बोलो तो कौन सा फाइल है शेप के हिसाब से, कितने फाइल आ चाहिए अकॉर्डिंग टू शेप जेटा मैं यूज कर ची वीडियो देखते तो बोलो.
अभी याद में नहीं आ रहा.
नहीं मालूम. अच्छा ठीक है. कौशिक साधु.
यस सर.
कौन सा फाइल है ये वाला जो हम यूज कर रहे हैं.
आई थिंक फ्लैट फाइल.
वेरी गुड, ये फ्लैट फाइल ही है. ठीक है जय चक्रवर्ती. ठीक है ना, ये फ्लैट फाइल है कंचन सरकार. दिस इज फ्लैट फाइल अकॉर्डिंग टू सेफ. कौशिक बता सकते हो कि डिफरेंट टाइप्स का फाइल कौन कौन सा है अकॉर्डिंग टू शेप.
सर फ्लैट फाइल, हैंड फाइल, स्क्वायर फाइल, ट्रायंगुलर फाइल, रेड टेल फाइल,
राउंड फाइल. राउंड फाइल, हाफ राउंड फाइल, रेस्ट कट फाइल. तो सॉरी वो तो कट है. अच्छा कंचन सरकार तुम सुन रहे हो. कंचन सरकार.
यस सर.
व्हाट इज द स्पेसिफिक यूज ऑफ राउंड फाइल.
राउंड फाइल सर फ्लैट सर सर 90 डिग्री मेजर सर राप
राउंड फाइल. नो राउंड फाइल. यस यूज ऑफ राउंड फाइल
सर टू
यूज ऑफ राउंड फाइल.
राउंड फाइल
कौशिक बोलो तो तुम.
डोंट नो सर.
राउंड फाइल का यूज क्या है. व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ राउंड फाइल. नहीं मालूम. नंदनी पॉल.
नंदनी पॉल
व्हाट इज यूज ऑफ राउंड फाइल. राउंड फाइल हैव यू सीन राउंड फाइल डूइंग प्रेजेंटेशन. नंदनी
सर कैन आई टेल.
यस
सर. इट इज यूज्ड फॉर रिंग और फिनिशिंग की होल आई थिंक.
It is used for rubbing or pressing key hole. No, wrong.
Sir, can I say? Sir, can I say?
Yes.
It is used for making semicircle.
Making semicircle. That is used for, sorry. At that time, we use half round pipe.
Sir, can
okay. I say? Okay. Bolo.
Sir, I think, sir, for sir cleaning of the surfaces in circular areas, sir, where flat file cannot be used.
Of course.
And, sir, in all that.
Okay. Round file is used for enlarging the round hole. Okay. Okay, students. Round file is used for enlarging the round hole. Square file is used for enlarging the square hole. Triangular file is used for the triangular surface. Or angle surface, also filing angular surface. Okay. Now, students, Maji sir will send the job sheet. There are some questions on the job sheet. Okay. Next time, you have to submit the lab report. On the lab report, you have to write first there will be index page. Okay. Some points. Is written there, name of the job, date of submission, date of issue. Okay, you have to fill that file. So 2 days your job will be already finished. My first part. So you have to provide today date starting of fitting job. Student, can you tell me the title of the job?
Sir, making mean fill
section. Another metal bit, okay. So you have to draw the write the some from the title to figure, okay, on the A4 page, white page, okay, and then you have to write the procedure on the next page, and then you have to write safety of the workshop, and after that you have to write the answer of the given questions. Okay, students.
Sir, where will you submit, sir?
In the next class.
Sir, in the next class. So not in classroom, go classroom.
In the class, go classroom of sir, Maji sir.
Sir, what to write in A4 size paper?
A4 size. Yes, A4 page. Okay, you have to give the margin. All sides.
Okay, sir.
But you'll give maximum margin in the left side, okay? For
okay, sir.
20 mm. At least 20 mm. Margin, okay? And you have to write the, your roll number and batch on the top of the margin. Margin line, okay? No, positively.
Sir, okay, sir. Bolchi, hello.
Yes, sir.
You students, you have prepared the file first and then kept it yourself. I just told you then where you submitted. Okay, we just prepare first your files, all the files you have to prepare it first and kept it yourself. Then I'll told you that where you submitted. Okay, next class I'll told you. Files, sir.
Yes,
we can stop. All of you give your name and roll number in the chat box. Send your name and number in the chat box. Hello.
Thank you, sir.
All of you send your name and roll number, roll number in the chat box. All of you have.
Students, any question?
Okay, okay. Thank sir. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. It is a good presentation. Good presentation.
Okay, sir.
हाँ चलो, we can stop here. We can continue. हाँ, all of उसके attendance ले लिया चल.
हाँ सर, ले रहे.
Okay. All of you send your name and roll number in the chat box. हाँ, ऑलमोस्ट हो गया. थैंक यू वेरी मच. वी कैन कंटिन्यू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. थैंक यू वेरी मच.